हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल अनफॉग विद डॉक्टर अतहर परवीन। फ्रेंड्स, आई एम मेकिंग दिस वीडियो टू गिव ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वार्निंग टू कर्नाटका टीईटी 2024 एस्पिरेंट्स, बिकॉज सम एस्पिरेंट्स आर मैसेजिंग मी टेलिंग दैट मैडम वी हैव स्टार्टेड प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर पीयूसी सिलेबस बिकॉज वी हैव सीन दैट न्यू साइंस सिलेबस फॉर कर्नाटका टीईटी 2024 published in the school education department website, and it is including the PUC science syllabus. So we have started preparing from PUC first year and second year physics, chemistry and biology. So I was worried about aspirants who are doing so. So that's why I am making this video, just to remind you all that please don't do this. See, actually the syllabus which they have given for paper 1 is this, right? For 10th standard, 9th standard and 6th to 8th they have given, right? Now, as per our TET old syllabus, we need to prepare for high school thing, right? Till 10th standard we have to study for science for paper 2 also. So I have been repeatedly telling aspirants to please prepare from high school first, especially from 9th and 10th standard science part. Please first finish this thing, then only go for PUC. Don't directly go for PUC syllabus because you have very less time now. So in that process of preparing from PUC syllabus, you are missing lot and lot of basic points from high school syllabus. And 99% chance is that they will ask all science questions from high school syllabus only, especially from 9th and 10th standard only. In preparing PUC syllabus, if you miss the basic points and your exam will be from high school, which includes the basic points, then how will you answer those questions? And first of all, one thing which you should understand is that you cannot prepare for PUC syllabus PCB within 15-20 days. It is not possible. In this process, you are just wasting your time. You are not getting perfect with high school also, and 100% you cannot prepare for PUC also. So please mark my words and please try to prepare from 9th and 10th standard science syllabus first. Okay, so this is the syllabus which you have to follow to prepare right now. Okay, what is that syllabus? From 10th standard, chemical reactions, acids, bases and salts, metals and non-metals, carbon and its compounds, periodic classification of elements, life processes, control and coordination in animals and plants, chemical coordination, heredity and evolution, reflection of light, then electric current, magnetic effects of current, sources of energy, our environment and management of natural resources. Okay, this much you should be perfect. You should go for higher level of these topics also. Okay. Then from 9th standard, you should prepare for matter, atoms and molecules, mole concept, structure of atom. In detail, you should go organization in living world, biological diversity, motion, force and work, force and Newton's law, gravitation, work energy and power, sound, health and diseases, natural resources and food production. Okay, if you are perfect with this much syllabus, then you can go for PUC level. Okay, now if you prepare so much, I mean to say the 9th and 10th standard syllabus perfectly, you are indirectly preparing for these chapters in physics: kinematics, Newton's laws of motion, work energy and power, gravitation, current electricity, magnetism and optics. Okay, and also you are indirectly preparing for some basic concepts of chemistry, structure of atom, chemical bonding and molecular structure, chemical kinetics, electrochemistry, p-block elements, aldehydes, ketones, carboxylic acids and organic compounds containing nitrogen. Okay, so this much you are indirectly preparing for chemistry from PUC first year and second year. And also by preparing from class 9 and class 10 perfectly, you are indirectly preparing for PUC syllabus of biology, which includes cell, biological classification, plant kingdom, animal kingdom, human physiology, reproduction in organisms, genetics and evolution, ह्यूमन हेल्थ एंड डिसीज, बायोटेक्नोलॉजी एंड एकोलॉजी. ओके, सो लेट मी गिव यू द मॉरल ऑफ माई स्टोरी, वॉट आई वॉन्टेड टू वॉर्न यू ऑल. द इम्पॉर्टेंट मॉरल, फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज, फर्स्ट मेक यूअर बेसिक्स स्ट्रांग एंड मेक श्योर दैट यू विल बी एबल टू आंसर ऑल ईजी क्वेश्चंस करेक्टली इन कर्नाटका टी टी 2024. दिस इज पॉसिबल ओनली इफ यू गेट परफेक्ट विथ यूअर हाई स्कूल साइंस सिलेबस, एस्पेशली 9th स्टैंडर्ड एंड 10th स्टैंडर्ड सिलेबस. ओके, देन टेस्ट यूअर सेल्फ फॉर मीडियम लेवल क्वेश्चंस. आर यू एबल टू आंसर द मीडियम लेवल क्वेश्चंस from high school, especially 10th standard and 9th standard. Okay, if you are perfect with everything, if you are 100% sure that yes, I am perfect with this, if they ask any question from 9th and 10th standard in science, I will give correct answer in Karnataka TET 2024, then only you should go for hard level if you have time. Hard level means go for PUC only then. Okay, so please mark my words and take it as a warning. Aspirants who have directly jumped to PUC syllabus preparation for TET, that is not the right method of preparation for TET 2024. Okay, you are not a high school teacher recruitment aspirant. You are not writing a HSTR recruitment exam. You are writing a teacher's eligibility test, which will test your basic knowledge first. Okay, so I really hope that this warning will help you all in making the right stage of preparation. First to go for basic stage, then go for medium stage, then go for hard level stage if you have time. Okay, or else no need. If you don't have time, don't go for hard level stage. I mean to say, don't go for PUC level if you don't have time. First to make yourself perfect with the high school syllabus, especially I'm talking about science. Okay, thank you, all the best, bye.